Hello
Hello student. Chủ đề
Today we
is
start
the
our session 6.
We begin the
the
second
second
half
half
of our
of
subject,
our
partial differential
partial
equation.
equation.
This
This
is
is
a
a
very
very
important
important
session
session
because
because
we will
we
discuss
discuss
the
the
most
most
important,
important,
the
the
most
most
powerful
powerful
tool
tool
to
to
solve
solve
all
all
three
three
partial
partial
equations
equation
that
that
you
you
meet
meet
in
in
that
that
semester.
semester.
This
This
is
is
a
a
severable
severable
method.
method.
In today's
Today's
session,
session,
we
we
will
will
discuss
discuss
first
first
introduction,
introduction,
next
next
severable
severable
for first
first
order
order
PDA,
PDA,
and
and
last
last
severable
severable
for
for
heap
heap
problem.
problem.
What the partial differential is, in fact, this still differential equation, but with function of several variables. So let's see that equation, for example. Here you say derivative respect t and respect s. So you have function of two variables, student. And when you have function of several variables, when you take derivative, you must yield partial derivative. So the official name, this is partial differential equation that we call shortly PDE. Distinguished. First half, we learn ODE. This is ordinary function of one variable. And now second half, we learn PDE. This is partial function of several variable. In our second half, we will study three kinds of PDE. First, this is heat. Second, this is white. And last, Laplace PDA. And I think, student, you can take a look. Do you see some similarity between heat and white? Yes, you see both are U and T. And you have the derivative. Understand? But do you see also the difference between heat and white? Heat, you have the derivative of T first order, derivative of U respect S second order. But for white equation, both derivative respect T and S are second order. And the last thing, for the Laplace equation, you don't have T. You have only S and Y. So student, sometimes when you have equation with T, when you have equation with T, sometimes we call this a dynamic. But if equation has no T, sometimes we call static. Okay, so dynamic student, this is equation with time. But Laplace, this is no time. And the last notion, student. Here, for heat equation, you have first order derivative respect T, second order respect S. So what is the order of this PDA? We will call the highest order of partial derivative. Understand? Respect whatever variable, this is the order of PDA. So here for three equations that we will study that semester, you see you have different derivatives. But the highest order as on y second. So all three are second order PDA. Okay, but besides, This is the first order respective. Why this is the second order respective. And that last you have noted. And now the last important notation, student. Because you have function of several variables, here two variables. So the domain of that function is some domain in plane, S and T. And if you have such domain, you will have boundary of domain. And if on boundary, the value of the function you must find is given, we will call that boundary condition Dirichlet condition. Understand? And generally, student, immediately you will see the use of the next statement. For general PDE, if you have equation inside and boundary condition like Dirichlet condition on boundary, so there is always and only one solution. That means, remember shortly, equation together with boundary condition will provide only one solution. Understand? So now, okay, this is on notion. Now we go directly straightforward to the bond today. But I must say the simulation technique for the heat equation is long. So let's train with the first order PDE. Now we ask you to solve that PDE equation. Partial derivative respect S equal 4 times partial derivative respect Y. Okay, now for this simple equation, student, I think you can immediately see the difficulty, the main difficulty of PDE. What the main difficulty is here, student? When you have differential equation, that means you have derivative. Which operation you must do to cancel the derivative? Surely integral. But now, left hand side, you have derivative respect S. Right hand side, you have derivative respect Y. Can you take integral one time for both hand side, but respect different variable? No way. Do you agree with me? You can multiply ds to both hand side that integral, but in this case the right hand side is okay under the difficult integral. How you can take integral when inside you have derivative respect y and ds together? So now student, this is the main difficulty, but very very amazing the separation technique student allows us to escape integral. What you do now, the main thing, we will look for solution in this form, student. Let's find USY equal SS multiplying YY. What's the bond is here? So you student still function of two variables. Understand? But two variables, they are separated. So you can see it looks like oil and water. You mix in one solution, but this not like salt in water. Oil on way above, water below, understand? So you have separated liquid. Now similarly, we have function of two variables, but they are separable. What happened with them? Now let's take the derivative respect S. What happened when you take this derivative? Y like constant. So you focus to only S. Similarly, UY, this A, S like constant, so you print outside. Do you see? If you suggest separated form, you can take easy derivative. Now, your equation becomes US, this A. UY So student, that very special form allows us to take easy derivative. Now next advantage student, if you have separable form for both hand side, you can print on S to one hand side, on Y to other hand side. So that means you will have S prime over S equal 4 times Y prime over Y. But now student, we have some strange phenomenon here. You see left hand side depends only on S. So if S change, left hand side change. Right hand side depends only on Y. But they are equal for on S Y. Do you understand? So it looks like I touch two brands. Understand? And now you are here, your brand in other room. Here you do anything, follow only your will. There, on other room, your brand does similarly on thing that you want. Can happen that your action and his action on white the same. Do you understand? But now this happened. How? This can happen. The only thing that the left and the right are equal constant. Do you understand? So okay, return to your example. You are here. He is there. But you cannot do nothing. You just sit down, I ask you, don't move. And there, your friend does the same thing, just sit down. Understand? Only in this case, we can say that your action and his action are always the same. You with me? So now student, the very important point of separable technique, you bring S one hand side, Y other hand side, you see left, depend on S, right, depends on Y. So if they are equal, they must be the same constant. Okay, we will note this a lambda constant.
So now, student, what happened now? You will receive the first equation, that one equal lambda. But when the left equal lambda student, do you still have PDE? Let's see equation S prime over S equal lambda. Do you still have PDE? Is there function of two variables? No. Now you have only function of one variable. That means now you return to the first half. You don't have any more PDE. You have only ODA. This is the bond there. We try to transform from PDE to ADE. And now you will see the solution of the first one is this is simulable. I will rewrite student S prime like DS over this mod S. So you will have that one. Equal lambda, understand? And the second equation the same. Dy over y. Dy, this is lambda over 4. And now by usual technique, you bring ds to right hand side. You take integral. You have integral d bit f over s equal integral lambda d small s. So you have logarithm s equal lambda s plus logarithm c1. So you have s. This is c1 exponential lambda s. Similarly, for the second equation, but now for y, and instead of lambda, you have lambda over 4, understand? So you will have answer. But student, we don't find the final goal. This not S and Y. The final goal is the function U. So U this is S multiply Y. And when we multiply C1 and C2, we get like new constant C. So you have this a C exponential lambda S plus lambda over 4y. So now you must find C and lambda, and attention, we have one condition that we did not use. So now that's a condition type. We got S equals 0. So u0 y, this is c. But that condition, I understand. And now, how this can happen? I think without any mathematics, you recognize directly c must be I. And lambda over 4, this is 3. But still done.
I must say that this solution, I believe, will raise some good students here. Teacher, do you have such technique at your high school? Let's imagine that if high school teacher asks you to solve some equation, you start with one suggestion. Now, I will suggest S in some special form. Can teacher accept? Never. So this technique, you can say rightly, teacher, this technique allows us to find only one special solution, understand? And our goal this is the set of all solutions, the general solution. We can lose some solution here. So this not our final solution, teacher. But let's see this condition still done. When, if you have such equation, so your domain still done, A, O, S, Y. And now you have condition when S equals 0, S equals 0 is that 1. So you see that line boundary. Understand? If you solve the equation on right half and together with boundary condition, what we already mentioned in last five student, equation inside boundary condition together. So how many solutions you have? Only one. Did you find such solution? We found it. So student, the statement that we mentioned last time, generally the BDA has only one solution. So now by whatever technique, if you find one solution, this is the solution you must find. Do you understand? So now student, we get that severable suggestion very, very relaxed form. Understand? And we never scare that we lose some solution else. So here, that one, equation plus BC, that means boundary condition. So you have only one. Oh, this is the problem when I write together with microphone student. And that is that one. Still done. Say only one thing forward. The discussion is long, but later you need only to type for all students. You remember the general form of solution. For good students, you remember only the main idea. And after that, you can be better. So first discussion is still that. We have the heat equation. Derivative respect T equal 4 times second derivative respect S on S from 0 to pi. And we have some conditions. First, let's discuss the picture. Why we have three conditions. Let's sketch the domain. So now you have equation for ST, so I will sketch student. This is the plan. And the first condition, S equals 0, so you have that one. The next condition, S equals pi. S equal by this tail vertical line. And finally, the last condition, T equal 0, so you have that side. So we say, in fact, our domain S from 0 to pi, T greater than 0, this is 1, rectangle, but infinitive rectangle, understand? And this rectangle has how many sides for boundary student? Three sides. So that's why you have three conditions here. You can say that all are boundary conditions, but in fact, student will distinguish. You see, when x, when t equals 0, that one. When t equals 0, physically, we usually call that kind of condition as. What happens when you have some problem with time and you have condition when time equals 0, student? We call this a initial condition. So that condition till 0, student, we call initial condition, I say. And to all the condition when n equals 0, when s equals 5, this loop real boundary, understand? So this one, we call boundary. That means student. In fact, all condition here are boundary, but we classify one like initial, t equals 0, others like boundary. And now, how we solve that problem? We will use student three steps. First step, student, we try to transform PDE into ODE. Understand? Next, we solve ODE and we will cut the general form. A condition. And finally, we find all missing constant there. So that means the initial condition will say the last one. So now, step one. Here, student. One more time, we use the separation technique. ST equals SSTT. So when you substitute derivative respect t, you have t prime multiply s equal 4 times second derivative respect s. So this is s 2 prime multiply t. Understand? And now, one more time, we print s one hand side t for order. So you have s 2 prime s over s equal t prime t for t t. And one more time, left depends on s, right depends on t. So it must be lambda equal constant. Understand? But we don't stop here, student. We will see what the boundary condition for you now becomes for s. Let's see, student, you have u 0 t. Under that assumption, this will be S0 multiply TT equals 0. And what happens when the product equals 0, student? At least one term must be 0. So now, the first case, if S0 like number different from 0, so you will have TT must be 0 for all t. And if t equals 0, how about function u? U equals 0. Understand?
And that solution, student, we call trivial solution. And here, temporarily, we don't consider trivial solution. That means we try to look for solution non-trivial. We will understand perfectly at the end why. At that step, we don't study, we don't touch trivial condition, zero solution in our consideration. Understand? So here, that one. Trivial. So, temporarily, we exclude from our study trivial solution. So, student, the second case, S0 equals 0, understand? So, that one we touch. Similarly, the condition yield by T and one more time we look for only non-trivial. So what conclusion you get here when S by multiply T equals 0 still done? S by still 0. Understand we don't spend attention to the KS by different from zero. So finally, student, for S, you will have problem S to frame minus lambda S equal zero and S zero equal S by equal zero. For T, you will have T prime T minus 4 lambda T. This is zero. So this is 2 ODA, understand? So the first step finished. Here, one explanation student. Some of you can ask me, teacher, why you take number 4 for T? Why you don't touch number 4 for the hand side with S? The problem is, student, now you have two different problems for S and for T. Which one will you start? You can see T, this is first order easier, but S we have more condition. So we will start from S. So that's why we want the equation with S as simple, simplest as possible. Do you understand? So all the factor I will bring for T. I will fit it with T later. But now we start with S, so we want our evolution, understand, as simplest. Okay, so the first step finished. Now we attack straightforward to the second step. I like to rewrite the equation that we have already here. So now, student, what you can tell me for this equation? S2 prime minus lambda S equals 0. If you still have difficulty, my advice, let us for this symbol number lambda equal 3. If I ask you S2 prime minus lambda S minus 3 S equals 0, what you must do? Let us lambda like any number, understand? For example, lambda equal 3. So you will find the old situation
you recognize this equation, this is just the second order ODE homogeneous. And you must write the auxiliary. So now, absolutely similarly student, we will consider that one like that equation is homogeneous. So you touch that one. Understand? And what is your K now? K squared equal lambda. K equal plus minus square root lambda. Are you sure? Okay, depend on lambda. If lambda negative, we must involve number I. If lambda positive, so here student like 9 class, you have 3 cases. Lambda greater than 0, lambda equal 0, lambda smaller than 0. And we will show you only one from 2 first cases. I chose same layer to show why we never take 2 first case in consideration. So student here, that means you have 3 cases. And when lambda greater than 0, you will have exponential solution. Understand? Lambda equals 0. Now the this guy we will write longer. You have k1 equal k2 equal 0. So your solution is s equal Riley C1 multiply exponential 0 s. That means C1 multiply 1 plus C2 s exponential 0 s. And condition s0, you substitute s0, so you have this is C1. Understand? And at that time, if you use s by the next condition, C1 equals 0 already. So one more time, you have C0 equals 0. But one, when C1 and C2 equals 0, that means when C1 and C2 equals 0, S equals 0. And when S equals 0, so you have U equals 0, and this is our trivial solution. So we don't take this to study. Similarly, student, we can show if you have exponential or polynomial solution, the boundary condition S0 equals S by equals 0 always lead you to zero solution. Do you understand? So three cases we never study, we accept student. You can say same layer, teacher, or to first kind, the boundary condition and the non-trivial assumption student lead us to zero solution. Understand? Okay, now we focus to the last guy. When lambda negative, I suggest lambda equal minus mu square. Okay, we take mu positive. Understand? So your equation k square equal lambda will be minus mu square, or I involve number I. So this is mu square, I square. So you have k this is plus minus mu I. Do you understand?
So alpha equals 0, beta equals mu. So your solution S will be C1 cos mu S plus C2 sin mu S. Now, let's take the validation S0. If you substitute S equals 0 there, so what you have? S equals 0. Sin 0. This is 0. And cos 0. This is 1. So, C1, this is 0, still done. So now your solution reduced to only sin. Understand? You continue with S by. So S by still done. In this case, we will see 2 sin mu by. One more time, the product is 0. So what can happen? What happened if C2 is 0?
Okay. Trivial. So, your dream come true. So, teacher, you, this you, who said that? Now we don't study true solution. And I show that you just said two first cases on why trivial. Now the last case, we have C1, this is 0, and we have C2, this is 0, one more time, trivial. So we have no study now. We can leave. Sorry for you. The second term, sin mu by destroys your dream. Okay, if this one equals 0, one more time, this is trivial. So we can not that understand. We must start the case sin mu by this is 0 still done. And what happened if sin this is 0? Okay, like high school, ninth class. Do you remember sin S equals 0, S equals?
0.
Okay, right. Very right. You just said your final score. What's his name? Please. Next week, remember me, his name, and his star. 2 weeks later, remember me one more time. Sin S equals 0, so S equals K by K. This is integer number. Not only 0, as you dream, as you are obsessed. The number 0 will follow you. So student, okay, I don't use number K there. K, this is already the symbol that we use equation. We will write mu by equal m by, where m this is integer number. Understand? So mu equal m, but we not mu positive here. So now student, finally, instead of m, I will take mu, this is n, where n, natural number. And so student, finally, you will have lambda, this is minus mu square, that means minus n square. Your solution, now not only one, but infinitive. This is sin ns, sin mu s here, understand? Why we don't not see the constant? You will see it later. And now student, that one finished for s. But now, don't stop here, because you must have the t. How about t student? You have equation t prime over 4 t Ecolanda. So you have equation t prime ln dt by dt minus 4 lambda t. That means plus 4 n square t equals 0. Understand? And this a separable easy ODA. Tắt dt by left hand side. Bring t there, student. So you will have minus 4 n t dt, tất integral. And what you have for t student? Logarit t this e minus 4 n square t plus logarit d. Understand? So now you have solution tn. This a d exponential for n square t. And finally, of second step, student, you have solution for s sin, you have solution for t exponential, and your yield this a. S T T understand. So you have the kind of exponential minus 4 n square sin n s n greater than 1. And finally, what you must do now, teacher, you have not only one solution but infinite solution. What you do? Remember, student, like homogeneous equation. When you have y1, y2 in solution, so your final solution is c1, y1 plus c2, y2. Here, if you bring u to left hand side, right hand side still zero, your equation is linear and homogeneous. So you yield the same rule. If you have some solution, like basic solution, your final solution will be the sum of basic solution. But the problem now, you have the sum of not only one term, but infinity term. And the sum of infinity term we call, what is the name of the sum of infinite term? We already studied last semester. FA4 building, I remember. Morning, you have several variables. Bachelorated. And afternoon, you have calculus tool. The sum of infinite term. I remember some students try to work the bar, so I'm sorry. Like you. But now, you don't remember. So I think that last semester you did me. Okay, now that's time to retreat you. I will give you the score that you worked last semester. When I say that semester, you don't remember. No. Okay, and Wesley. So now, what is the name of the sum of infinite term? Student. All the class, they are not sure because I some student, I think they didn't study with me, but you studied with me last semester. The sum when n from 1 to infinity. Secret? Who? Who dares you with that? Okay. Good news. So, Mr. answer Võ Hoàng Duy. What we must do now, very easy. My daughter now is still abroad. She will return later. So I want to keep Mr. Võ Hoàng Duy near me. So I can talk to him. So, okay. I think you can consider your presentation every ED class next semester and next year. I must be sure that you are there. I give you a chance to fulfill your dream. Firstly, stay in there forever. So now, return student, what is the name, English name of the song series? Very easy. So now, student, don't surprise that. We son. I must say why I highlight that point. A lot of students, they cannot remember formula and first question from them for me. Teacher, why in ODE we have such solution? But when you remember the sum of imitative probability series, now you can understand your final answer here, student. This A. U is the sum n from 1 to 50 multiply constant that we know the n exponential minus 4n square t sin ns. Do you understand? It's very long but it's reasonable. Okay, now I rewrite one more time. Student, we have okay, the bond A here, student, I like to recall you that, for example, if you take equation, easy, y squared, y2 prime minus y equals 0, how to solve it? You take k squared minus 1, and you have how many k? Understand? In fact, excuse me, k is go 1 and k is go minus 1. And now, from k, in fact, you can show that y1 is exponential s, y2 is exponential minus s, and solution of that one. But this is only particular, but very, very specific that we call basic solution. And now, from basic solution, how you can find the general solution? Why this is C1Y1 plus C2Y2. Let's see what happens with that equation if I bring that term to right hand side, left hand side. Do you see some similarity between this ODE and that PDE? First, Y like variable, so you have left hand side on with y, right, this is zero, we call homogeneous. Here, u this is variable, so left this is u on term with u, right, this is zero. Next, for ODE, you find two basic solution, so your solution general, this is the sum. Here, you have how many basic solution on exponential multiply sin arrive with n greater or equal 1. Do you understand? So your solution, your general rule will be the same. Multiply constant, that's the sum. And the sum, this is not the sum of two term or 10 term, but infinitive term. So you have series. But I must assure you, don't worry, Siri is just informed because now for some easy next step student, you will cancel the Siri sign very fast. So now, do we read all conditions already? Did we use all conditions? No, this still initial. So if you touch t equals 0 student, so first, exponential of 0, this is 1. You will have bn sin ns, this is the function yield, equal that 1, 3 sin s minus 5 sin 4 s. So now let's see the last identity. You must see that the left hand side is the sum of sin, but the right hand side is the sum of sin 2. So now the last step for first order BDA, you can apply any condition you want just to be sure that the left and the side, the right are the same. So how we do that? Sin s here, this is n equal 1. So you get B1, this is 3. Do you see sin ns comes with Bn? Ns sin 4s, that means n equal 4. So you have B4, this is minus 5. And how about all the Bn? Okay, cancel. For on n different 1 4. Understand? And now you can write the final solution. You this a first B1, so you have 3 n equal 1, so minus 40 sin s. Understand? Next, n equal 4, before this is minus 5, so minus 5 exponential n equal 4, so 16 multiply 4, so minus 64 t sin 4n, and this is the final solution. Okay, I think you really worry if the solution is too long like that. So how we can solve one problem? Okay, what I suggest you now, student, let's solve. In this part, identify s from 0 to pi, understand? And we have the same boundary condition. And we have that one. So now how we solve? In fact, student, the problem seems very long, but when you repeat your study, do you have to do new thing? You suggest the same simulation form, you substitute, you print the term to F, right? So you must see that your solution for C, because you print the number 4, last time number 4 here, student, to T. So the form for C must be the same, sin and S. And the number 4 you used last time appears in the final form only for exponential. So that means now you can write directly UST, what your UST is. Read loudly together with me the series symbol and from 1 to 50 of how much student? Bn. Later you will see you will have cos answer. So we use A for cos, B for sin. And next, exponential
minus 5 and sweaty, understand? Sin and S. And now you treat the insulation, you substitute, you get the sum BN sin NF this A for sin 3F. So you have only one B different from zero this A. B 3 equal 4. And your final answer, student. B 3. That means we take N equal 3. N equal 3. So this A 9 multiply 5. Exponential minus 45 t sin 3x. That's all. That's why students, we spend a lot of attention to the separation discussion. But when you understand, you need not repeat on the step, on the previous steps.
Okay, so you say the separable for heat problem. Now, we start and the last one. Go to BKEL, play at the whisk. Use the whisk. With the password. GT, you understand? 1, 4, 0, 6. 6 letters. GT, 1. For our seat, and thank you for your attention.